After my deployment to Afghanistan, my wife got severely depressed, and we had to deal with that. My youngest son, when he was 8, came to me and told me he wanted to die, had a plan, and had actually started to do his plan and then stopped and came and talked to me instead. And then I went through a period of time back in 2017 or so where I was just going through a dark phase and wound up, it was actually my daughter who said, you know, there's something going on and you might need to talk to somebody. And it's funny because as much as I tell other people, you need to go talk to somebody, I didn't do it because I'm a chaplain, right? People are supposed to look at me in a certain way. But I did go talk to somebody, which led to me getting on some medication for about a year and a half. I just needed a little help getting over this hump. And then once I got better, if you will, I was fine. Mental health is no different than your physical health. So if you break an arm, nobody feels guilty about going to the doctor and getting your arm set. In fact, people would look at you like you were crazy if you walked around with a broken arm and allowed it to, you know, be all twisted and stuff for the rest of your life. Mental health is the same. It's just we can't see it. All you're doing is getting your emotions reset, your mind reset, your heart reset, and it's no different than going and getting a bone set. We have a very deep undercurrent of I gotta be tough, you know, and this kind of thing. And I think it takes a lot of toughness to admit, hey, there's something going on, and for the sake and good of everybody, I'm gonna go get help.